Welcome in, everybody. I'm Joey, back again here on the most technically advanced racing game ever made. They said it, not me. Don't get mad at me. This is the Formula 70 series. I'm in the BRM. We're going up against some low-tie McLarens and Ferraris. And this guy, suspiciously named Kamikaze, is taking a narrow line into turn one. Instead, it's actually a guy behind that's doing the dive bombing on me harder than the USS Arizona, but he just gets spun out right away, so we don't really have to worry about him anymore. Coming into turn two, there's bound to be some more guys off. There is one guy pretty deep in the sand, and the two up front, slight touch, and one is off into the grass, turning into a lawnmower. Another one knocking some boards as he travels along the grass as well. These 70s Formula One cars are notoriously hard to handle in this game, but every once in a while, you come up against another driver who is going to give you a really good race, and this one certainly developed into a very good one. But like any race in Forza, especially ones where you're starting towards the back or in the middle like we are here, gotta stay patient, avoid the professional dive bombers, and let things settle in. Fortunately, this race, we do have plenty of time as I get the car up on the two wheels here, turning the thing into a bike for a second. But as I was saying, we got 8 laps in this one, so we'll go 4 laps on these stock tires, and then we'll pit, get another set of stocks, and that means we've got plenty of time to let this race settle in and figure things out. Coming out of the carousel, ironically, Kamikaze has not sunk me to the bottom of the harbor yet. We're still chugging along, and we gave each other plenty of space, some decent driving there, which is always good to see. For those of you wondering, I did lift through the high speed right because I am a coward. This channel's already been up for a year, and I'm pretty sure I've eaten shit around that corner like 7 million times, so forgive me for driving to my ability sometimes. I know most of you are here to watch me bury my face in concrete and suck in some grass into the engine, but just, you know, bear with me here. It'll come. Your time will come. So here we are finishing off lap one. Overall, a pretty decent start, getting a feel for the car. Here was an interesting strategy from me. I carried too much speed around the corner. The guy in front didn't carry enough. And, well, I didn't have time to swerve to the right. I swerved to the left, which is where the fucking grass is, by the way, if you didn't notice. Which is actually kind of ironic, because I just watched a Jimmy Broadbent video where he took a Formula One car off-roading around a rally track. So I think his probably worked out a little better. I didn't make the pass while I was off-road, but I did actually get it done by the time we got to the end of the straight. Warriors is coming back at me, though, down this back straight here. Ideally here, I'd take the grass line as well, but he's got me pinned to the outside, so I guess I'll take the normal racing line and settle in behind him. Kamikaze is still hanging close behind, but the leader is starting to pull away as we come around this left-hander. That gap will get up to about 7.5 seconds. Warriors pulled away through there as well, but heading into turn 12 down the straight, I've got another opportunity for a dive bomb of my own up the inside. It's not necessarily the BRM specialty, though, and of course, my driving, my mediocre-ass driving, is not helping as well, but to put it simply, the brakes on this thing are le garbage en français, if I may. And to loop my fellow Americans in, they suck. So where we're really going to make our money in this BRM is coming out of the corners. The acceleration on this thing is top of the class. The top speed is mediocre, but yeah, that acceleration out of the corners is where I'm going to have to win this one. So to kick off lap three, looks like we're going to have a good old-fashioned ball-size comparison contest on the brakes into turn one between the two up ahead. Warriors is going to win out. I'll slip up the inside of Tinsel Coyote. That'll be seventh place for us. Moving back over to the left, breaking on that last WeatherTech board. A slight tap on the guy in front. Tinsel Coyote popping up the inside. That just throws me off enough to start filling up the intakes with more grass, and I'm quickly falling behind once again. At this point, they might as well just add like a lawn bag upgrade, because we've already got drift suspension and drag tires, which are totally pointless right now with no support. So let's just get some grass bag upgrades to throw on the back of all the cars, just for shits and giggles. I think that's a good idea. Just in case you needed another reason to add them in, here's some more lawn mowing for you. But this was actually good, because this broke up the four-way battle that we were having, and this leaves Flareman and I to get down and dirty, get personal, get to know each other a little bit, sparks fly, let the racing begin, because we found a pretty good matchup here. Out of the carousel again, the back end getting a little loosey-goosey, probably losing a tenth or two from that into the kink to the right in that slipstream, carrying quite a bit of speed through there, and we are on the prowl, starting to catch up the Flareman here. moving to the right, going for that inside move again into turn 12, heavy on the brakes. And all of a sudden, I spot these two knuckleheads holding hands as they rail each other into a tire wall. So I was momentarily up into fourth place, but of course, Flair Man slipping underneath, grabbing fourth away from me, putting me back down into fifth. Coming around the last turn, hopefully carrying quite a bit of speed to keep up with that McLaren. As far as I can tell, this is going to be a pretty evenly matched battle between these two cars. They do different things well. He'll be winning the battles through the corners, but I'll be winning when we accelerate out of them. So approaching turn one, he's got the front wing alongside, but just backing out there, maybe he wants to work together, try to catch up the third place. That sounds good to me, but at the same time, he probably hasn't noticed my tendency to take cars off-roading relatively frequently, at least in this race, but it is going to work out for him here. We're going to catch up to third place. He dipped a couple of tires on the inside of the right-hand turn there, and we'll slip by him up into third place. And that'll finish off lap four. We'll head into the pits. Those stock tires starting to go off there, so we'll get another set of those and head out in fourth place. Now, the leader has not pit yet, so if all goes to plan, when we get back to this point next lap, the leader will have pit, and we'll be back up into third place, back on that podium. But that guy behind, sticking close, wants to put a wrench in the plans, and me drifting wide through turn two is definitely not helping. Although, we didn't go off into the grass again, so if there's a silver lining, that's it. The McLaren is still coming in hot in that slipstream, though, so drifting over to the left side to hopefully try to force him the long way around onto the brakes in between that 3 and 2 board, and the defense is successful. Is he going to try to slip up the inside on the way out? Nope, we've got that covered. So yeah, we defended the first attack, but now we're getting into the home court advantage for the McLaren through all these twisty turns, and almost immediately, I'm dropping the damn ball. The McLaren goes on through. I'm back down into fifth place. Now the goal becomes, let's just try to stick with this guy, get to the carousel, get around it, still behind him, get that extra boost of speed down the straight, see if we can get the pass again into turn 12. I've kind of botched that pass a couple of times though, going for the dive bomb into turn 12, so maybe, fingers crossed, this time it'll be a little different. We are still stuck behind him here, but once we come out of that right-hand turn, I'm really starting to pull up alongside now. This will give me the inside for the righty coming up, breaking just between those two boards on the left side. He's going to pinch me narrow, and I'm not going to get a good exit. That was some good driving from him because I could not get around that corner and carry the speed through there. That's some really good defensive driving from him there, and fair too. He left me just enough space on the inside. We did make some contact, but not too much where one of us ends up turning around and facing the wrong way, so I'll take it. I did strike out through turn 12 again, so hopefully at some point I can actually get a pass done through that corner, but we'll just have to wait and see. We'll start lap 6, and I've gotten about a car length ahead into turn 1. I was kind of thinking at this point that he might be trying it around the outside, but no, he settled for the racing line. Didn't make me look like a total idiot again. I'll hold on to third place for the time being, but very well knowing that on this next straight, we'll probably have another flip-flop of positions after I'm done eating my turnly dose of grass, apparently. Not daily, but turnly. It's that bad. It's gotten that bad for me this race. But here we go down the straight. Sure enough, Flair Man up into third place, and here he's going to kind of make me look like an idiot, just going right around the outside. I just cannot get the brakes on this thing to work. In other words, I need to grow some balls and break a little later. So it's deja vu again. Got to stick with this McLaren through the next couple of turns and around the carousel until we can get to that straight. Same thing as last lap. Let's stick in that slipstream and try to get around him on the straight. Fortunately for me, he went kind of defensive into turn 8. That kept me very close and gave me a kind of smart, maybe also really dumb opportunity to try it around the outside of the McLaren, and I just about stayed alongside there. It would be a death sentence to take the next one around the outside, so I'm going to let off the gas, take the racing line into the turn, and just speed right around him that way. That was probably the smartest thing I've done all race, now sticking to the right side, forcing him to go the long way, and can we finally get a pass done through turn 12? Nope, I've completely given it up again. I cannot get this damn car to turn. An epic failure through turn 12 once again. Fuck that corner. Fuck that corner with a passion. I'm not going to call it turn 12 anymore. I'm just going to say fuck that corner. Fuck that corner coming up. It's clearly in my head. You could probably blindfold me, chop off both of my thumbs, and then have me take that corner better than I have all six times so far this race. Regardless of my driving being fit for a man with no thumbs, the leader did end up going into the pits here, so that'll put me and our opponent here up into second and third place. So we're both going to get a podium spot here. It's just going to be who's standing taller than the other at the end of the race once we cross that finish line. The leader might be a little too far ahead to consider first place being a possibility. 13 seconds in two laps trying to make that up is quite a bit. So first place, out of the realm of possibility, but the good news is that fourth place is about 5.5 seconds back, so neither of us will most likely drop off of the podium. Now, for pretty much the entire race, I've just been hoping for this McLaren to make a mistake, but he hasn't. He's been flawless for the most part until the next couple of turns. I get a sliver of hope that I might be able to pull away, extend that gap, and get out of the draft range. Turn 7, gap goes up to about 0.5 seconds. Turn 8, gap up to almost 8 tenths now, and we're going into the carousel. So can we get the gap over 1 second, break that slipstream, and start to pull away down the straight? That would be huge with 1 lap to go. We sure can as we pass under the bridge out of slipstream range, but of course, you know what's coming up. Fuck that turn is next, and I'm not happy about it, but there's no way around it, so I got to take it head on. Hopefully, I don't botch it incredibly bad this time, and I don't, but I did take it pretty damn slow. I gotta admit I took it pretty damn slow, and in the end was able to build on that gap a little bit more, cross the line in that second place. Just a really fun battle there that I wanted to show you guys, and shout out to M Flair, man. I hope that's how you say the name correctly. Awesome race with that guy. That is not where the story with M Flair, man, ends though. Unfortunately, there was another chapter to this story. So we're at Suzuka, again, fighting for second and third, except I've completely lost my head, have no idea what a racing line is, had a brain aneurysm or something, and I'm all over the place. Get on the power a little too early out of the corner, and what do you know? I'm gonna go for a little beach vacation. Not great, Joseph. Not great. But I did want to show you guys the clip so that if we do ever come up against Flair Man again in one of these races, we know where the battle, the rivalry stands. We're all square at 1-1. Anyways, guys, that'll do it for me. If you enjoyed, do all the stuff YouTubers tell you to do at the ends of videos, and I will talk to you soon. Alrighty. Bye, everybody.